Thank you for the introduction. I would like to thank. I think it works. It works. It's already done. Yes. Thank the organizers for this invitation to speak in this conference in honor of Fontaine and the memory of Fontaine and Jean-Pierre Vincent Berger. It's quite emotional for me, you can imagine. I will revisit joint work I had with Deligne, which is now over 30 years old. In fact, this work, to some extent, was complementing results obtained by Fontaine, Messing, and Cato just a couple of years earlier. So let me just recall what it was about. So you start with the field K, which is perfect, of characteristic P. As usual, denote by W, between on K and W and truncated way. Now, if you have a scheme X over spec K, though it is not really necessary, but it's convenient to look at its pullback by the Frobenius automorphism sigma of spec K, which I denote by X prime, so that the absolute Frobenius of X factors through the relative Frobenius F from X to X prime. And if you look at the Durham complex of X over K, then this direct image by F becomes in fact a complex of OX prime modules. And I recall that if X over K is smooth, then its cohomology sheaves are described by Cartier isomorphism from omega I X prime to Hi of X. Now, the one of the main results X is a smooth scheme over K, and its dimension smaller than P, then with any lifting of X, or equivalently X prime to W2, is associated a decomposition in the derived category of X prime, sum for I in Z of omega I X prime minus I to F lower star omega X. I will drop the over K, so in D of X prime for X prime, inducing the Cartier isomorphism on each I. So this complex turns out to be the direct sum of its cohomology sheaves suitably shifted. In fact, this theorem 1 was a consequence of the following prime, 1 prime, where you start with X over K, smooth. But you don't put any assumption on the dimension. And the statement is that to any lifting of X to W2 is associated a decomposition, but a truncated decomposition, so Ox prime plus omega 1 x prime minus 1, to the truncation here, the truncation, the canonical truncation, where you cut in degree greater than 1. I will just write d of x prime for d of x prime of x prime, inducing Cartier, of course. Of course, this was a simple matter to deduce 1 from 1 prime by multiplicative properties of the both sides in here. And my goal today is to show some new thing about this, which is theorem 2. So let x over k smooth. So no assumption on dimension, no lifting, then there exists a canonical isomorphism in d of x prime between you take the truncation in degree at least minus 1 of the cotangent complex of x prime over w2, you shift it by minus 1, and again you take tau at most 1 of the Durham complex. This is strange because there is no lifting, and it's not so obvious how cotangent complex and Durham complex can be related. But let me show you why theorem 2 implies theorem 1 prime. So first you look at k, we have w2 and w. Then looking at the transitivity triangle for cotangent complexes, you find that L k over w2 is k of 2 plus k of 1. Now, suppose you have a lifting of x over w2, say x tilde, and so this is smooth, the square is Cartesian. Then L, the cotangent complex Lx over x tilde, is the pullback of the cotangent complex of L over w2. So it will be Ox of 2 plus Ox of 1. And now if you look, because this is smooth, the square is Tauro independent, and the cotangent complex of x over w2 is the sum of the cotangent complex of x over x tilde and cotangent complex of x over k, which is that omega 1 x over k, since x is smooth. And so you take x prime here, you apply tau at most minus 1, so this part disappears, so you get Ox prime of 1 plus omega 1 x prime over k, and then you shift by minus 1. So you get Ox prime plus omega 1 x prime over k of minus 1. And you have by theorem 2 you have the tau at most one of the stars. So you get theorem one prime. So this is quite the simple observation. And in fact, of course, as you know, the decomposition theorem I recall here had many applications to when X is proper, to degeneration of a Hodge-Duderham spectral sequence, both in characteristic P and in characteristic zero, and also to Codera-type vanishing theorems, both in characteristic P and characteristic zero. But concerning this this improvement somehow, theorem two, there are several remarks I should make. First of all, there was another result in my paper with Deligne, which I will recall. This is a special case of this result. So you can look at the local liftings of x to W2. So they exist because x is smooth over k, and any two local liftings are isomorphic locally. So they form a gerb. So lift of x or x prime of W2. And similarly, this truncated Durham complex here, which has H0, which is O, x prime, and H1, which is omega 1, x prime, admits decomposition in derived category, at least locally, and any two such decompositions are also locally isomorphic. So then you get also a gerb of the splitting of tau at most one of f star omega x. And in fact, there was a theorem one double prime in DI that there is an equivalence like this. But this is also a simple consequence of theorem two, because this gerb of the local liftings of x prime is in fact naturally identified to the gerb of splitting of tau minus one of L x prime W2 by associating to x prime the decomposition x prime W2 is or a truncation here omega 1 x prime plus or x prime of 1. And so you have an isomorphism here, so an isomorphism between the gerb of splittings. the other thing I would like to mention is that there have been several variants of this and generalizations. So first of all, there is a variant of this result over some base S of characteristic P, where S is over spec FP, and flatly lifted to spec W2. So in this case, if you start with an X which is smooth over X, then you have to be careful to distinguish between X and X prime, and the gerb of liftings of X prime to W2 is to S tilde is X prime to S tilde is in fact tau at most one of F star omega X over S. So this is smooth, of course. In fact, that can be proved along the same line as theorem two. Though it's a bit different, but not so difficult. And in fact, more or less the The lifting here corresponds to a truncation of the cotangent complex, and this isomorphism in theorem 2 can be generalized here to x prime over still is isomorphic and shifted by minus 1 is isomorphic to this. This and two statements are somehow equivalent. So generalizing to a more general base S is not much. And now the other, which is more interesting, is that Bat gave the prismatic variant. So I don't know much about prismatic cohomology, but roughly it goes like this. You have X over S, and S is in T, and then you T is a prism, so it's a spec R, and inside you have the ideal I in R, which is periodically, so you assume that R is periodically complete and I complete in the derived sense, and then you assume that some condition about the Frobenius. So you also you have some delta structure, so you get a lifting phi of the Frobenius, and then S is just a variety of zero of I. And you have something formally smooth. It's crystalline. Prismatic cohomology looks like crystalline cohomology. So you have a map new from X prism over T like this to X Zariski, and I think the statement is that you take L X over T, which will turn out to be in the previous case the same as this truncation of L X prime over W2. We'll explain that in a moment. Then to this shifted by minus 1 is isomorphic to our new lower star of O X over T, to take a truncation at most 1 of this, and here you tensor over R with I mod I square. So now if you take T to be spec W and I to be P, then by Hochstedt comparison theorem or crystalline comparison theorem, you get again the theorem 2. So in fact, I got this in a mail from Bat, and now I see that the proof has appeared in the paper of Anschuss and Lebra. So this is one of the connection with the current topics. Other, of course, generalizations. You have log variant. You find again some results of some improvements of and results of Kato, and some more recent result by I think Shang, Mao Shang, and Shen Tu. Anyway. The most interesting for me, the interesting one for me is the LCI generalization. So, but if I have time at the end, I will say some words about it. When you replace smooth by locally complete your section. So let me explain the proof of theorem 2, because it's so simple somehow. So So Preliminary remarks. I looked at the cotangent complex of x over w2. But you see, you have x over spec w, here you have spec w2, and here you have spec w. So actually, x is smoother, spec k here, smoother spec k, so this is a locally complete intersection, so Lx over w is a perfect amplitude in minus 1, 0. And in fact, it goes on to at least minus 1 of Lx over w2. And if you look at the corresponding triangle here for zero and h minus one h zero, then you will find that this is an isomorphism. So it's much nicer to work with Lx over w, which is in fact the Lx over t, which appeared here. So this is the first thing. And second, how do you calculate concretely the cotangent complex of x over w? Then, maybe I can list this. Suppose you have a closed embedding of x into a smooth scheme over w. So this is a minor restriction on x. And then there is a very simple definition, calculation of this cotangent complex. So suppose you have the x, so spec k. I think the other choke was better, maybe. This one was better. Yeah. You have spec w. And here you have. So this is an embedding, so ideal J, embedding, not a lifting. Then the cotangent complex of L over W, of X over W, is just a complex concentrated in degree minus 1 and 0, which is J mod J square, goes by D, 2 O X tensor omega 1. Y over W. So this is in degree 0, in degree minus 1. So in fact, you have a natural isomorphism like this. And actually, this is this way that the cotangent complex was discovered by Grothendieck, I think, in probably 1964, 1965. You know, he was in the GA4. He introduced a so-called module of imperfection, and this is important in the inseparable extensions and conditions in the excellency, so the local algebra, deep local algebra in GA4, and you observe that this module of imperfection was somehow paired with omega 1, and it was much better to look at a complex with cohomology omega 1 and imperfection modules than with the modules of cohomology themselves, and that led to construction of this truncated cotangent complex. So anyway, now I will give the proof of the theorem 2. So first, a special case. A special case. I will assume that not only I have an embedding of x into y smooth or w, but also I will assume that I have some endomorphism f of y, which lifts the Frobenius of White tensor K. So now, how can you compare this contingent complex and the truncation here? Well, curiously, it will come through the Durand-Witt complex of x over k. So this is queer because a priori there is no, so this is a strange object and there is no connection, obvious connection with both sides, but still. So first of all, you have this y with endomorphism f lifting the Frobenius. So then by you can assume if you like that y is formally smooth over spec w, so periodically complete. So then you have the Cartier section of the projection of WY to OY. Note that this is not a characteristic P, but still with vectors exist, and there is an local section, there is a unique section which is compatible with the lifting F here and the Frobenius F here. So you take this section, the morphism of ring, and then from it you deduce, of course, a map from omega y, the Durand complex, to the Durand complex of Wx.
So you go to Wx
or
Wy?
Oh, sorry, to Wy. Thank you, yes, of course. Thank you. Yes. S. Thank you, yes. So you have the SF, like this. So you compose with the 2WY. And so you have this. And so you look at these compositions, your omega Y goes to here. And then this, of course, goes to. There is a canonical map into the Durand-Witt complex of X. So you have, in this way, you find a canonical map C. So now if you look again at this map from OY to WX, so y to w of x, so it goes to w of y, and like this. And here you can look at the projection onto x. And here you have the y. And here this is the identity. Here the projection. So the ideal here is j. And the ideal here is w of x. So then this map C0, if you like, sends in fact J into VWX. Okay, so now you want to analyze more closely what happens to the Durand complex. So then you will consider the following subcomplexes of omega Y. So this will be JR goes to JR minus 1 omega 1 Y, goes to etc., goes to omega R Y, goes to omega R plus 1 Y, etc. So you have a filtration here with omega Y is G0. contain G1, etc. Now, what is the first associated, the associated graded in degree 1? So, the grow one for G of the omega Y, what is it? So you take degree 0 J mod G square, and then what do you find? You find omega Y modulo G omega Y, that is OX. That's omega 1. Why? So degree 0 and 1, and after that you find 0. So this is the cotangent complex of Lx or W shifted by minus 1. Now, we have seen that C sends, you have here OY goes to WOX. So J goes to VWX. Now, if you look at VX, VY, you will find the P VXY. So more generally, JR will go to P to the R minus 1 VWO. And so it's natural to introduce the following filtration of the Durham-Witt complex, which was first considered by Nygaard in 1981. So N0 W omega contain N1 W omega, etc. NR W omega, where N0 is just W omega, and for R at least 1, then NR W omega is, well, you start with the P or minus 1 V W X, then you go to P minus 2 minus 2 V W omega 1, etc. And you have the V W omega or minus 1, W omega R, and W omega R plus 1, etc.
So W omega is a filtration by so this is V means that V applied to W omega. It's not
yes.
It's not the V plus D.
Okay. No. Okay. So then we see that C maps JR omega Y to NR, W omega. Now we have seen the Gre 1 J of omega calculated. So now we want to understand the Gre 1 here, or more generally Gre R N W omega. So this is the result of Nygaard, which calculates this. So let me recall it. You consider the map from NR W omega to tau at most R of S F lower star omega X, which is defined as follows. For I So actually, it will be a map from. I should to keep track of the sigma linearity. I should put an x prime here. So for I smaller than r, so you send p r minus 1 minus I v x to x. For I equal r, you send x to fx. And for I greater than r, I mean the class in the height inside, you send x to 0. So actually, it factors through a map from Gre r n of w omega to tau at most r f star omega x. And the theorem of Nygaard is that star is a quasi-isomorphism. So now we are in good shape to prove our theorem. First of all, I should say that there are simplifications to this proof now by in the BLM, but Lurie-Mathieu. But still, this is basically the same idea. So now, what do we have? Well, we have this L x prime over W. So it goes by some isomorphism derived category to Gre 1 J of omega Y. So now this goes to Gre 1 Nygaard of W omega x, and then this prime, and then this goes to tau at most 1 by quasi-isomorphism here, a star omega x. Now, the construction here involves the choices, the y and the f. But the composition here does not depend on choices. Of y f, because if you have two choices, y1 f1 and y2 f2, then you can embed into the product y1 cross y2 with the lifting f1 cross f2, and then you have the compatibility between the composition, they will be the same. So now we want to show that the composition is an isomorphism. Then this becomes a local question. So then you can assume local question, so can assume that y being not only a lifting, not just an embedding, but in fact a lifting, so y lifts x, and then you have to unravel what is this this map here. And in fact, the map which appears here, the composition, will turn out to be, then you have OX, sorry. So the filtration becomes, you have P, so you get OX, and you have 0 here, and then so X prime, and then here you get omega 1 X prime. So this is this part here. And the map goes to, well, the truncation, that is OX to the cycles here. And what is the map? Well, in degree 0, this is the Frobenius. And in degree 1, this is the divided Frobenius induced by by dividing the operations on the omega 1y defined by f. F star is divisible by P, you divide by P, you get a lifting of Frobenius, you get a lifting of Cartier, and so this Cartier induces Cartier, and then so that disposes of the case where you have an embedding, and if you do not have an embedding, then still you can find an embedding system, and you work upstairs on the suitable co-skeleton, and then standard techniques of conjugal descent will give the result. I would like, because I have still some time, to explain some new viewpoint about this. Stemming from derived Durham complexes. So we are going a little more in the derived geometry business. So input from L omega. So I have to recall what is the derived Durham complex. So suppose R is an A algebra, then you can consider its standard free resolution, simplicial resolution over A. So P of R, standard free resolution. So P0 of R, so it's an enormous resolution. I mean, the components are enormous. P0 of R is A of the underlying set of R. P1 of R is A of A of R, etc. And, well, the cotangent complex is of R over A is defined by applying omega 1 to this and tensoring with R. So the derived Durham complex L omega R over L omega R over A is defined as the, so I denote by S what is sometimes denoted by tot, the simple associated complex to L to omega P dot R over R. So this is a simplicial in the, so in the in this degree, and then there is the Durham differential in the vertical direction. So you get here you get essentially a complex which is concentrated in the second quadrant, and you take a simple associated complex defined say by sum, because a priori there might be infinite
so
number
of. So the product gives a different definition.
Different definition. I take the sum here. Okay. Yes. Because in fact I will truncate, so then. So anyway, this comes in fact equipped with the filtration. Here you take some associated complex to omega at least I of P of R, the R. So this is the called fill I, Hodge. We sometimes drop the Hodge of L omega, R over A. And as this is completely functorial, this globalizes on schemes. And then you get, for any X over S, you get derived Durham complex so globalizes on schemes, and so get L omega X over S with filtration fill I which is essentially L omega at least I. And the associated gradient is I for the Hodge filtration, L omega, Well, of course, it's omega I, but placed in degree in positive degree I, so it is omega I of this simplicial resolution. So essentially, the cotangent complex of which you take the exterior power, derived exterior power. So this is L omega I x over k minus I, where L omega I x over k is L lambda I of L x over k. So you have that. So now the theorem 3 is the following. Suppose x over k is smooth, as before. Then there exists... So I hate this expression, there exists a canonical, but I don't have any... So in fact, we will define, we will construct, etc. So a canonical isomorphism. Well, in what? Well, I will write in the df of x and w, so the filter derived category of w modules on x. But in fact, there is a refinement of this derived category when you take complexes of differential operators of order at most one, where the filtration is graded, is associated graded is linear, so this category is introduced by Deligne and used by Dubois, and this is sort of a category we have here. The graded will be all linear. So the isomorphism is like this, is that you take L omega x and be defined by phil p for the Hodge filtration. And here you have the w omega x divided by np, so the Nagar filtration. So let me. So can in df, so it means that the filtration here is compared with filtration. Here you have phil I mod phil p, which will correspond by an isomorphism to n I mod n p. So a few corollaries of this. I will say maybe later a few words on the proof. But a few corollaries.
By the way, if you take the product complex and mod it by phil...
I'm sorry. So no. Lx over W mod phil p, yes. Sorry, this is very important here to take Lx over W. Yeah, sorry.
So when you mod by phil p, it doesn't matter if you take the sum of the product and the total complex.
Because there is only a finite number of this. Because then you get this. In any case, I chose the sum, right? But I think this is in this case. Yes, because then the omega I plus 1 is there. So you.
Oh, yeah, but I remember there was some question. Okay, I didn't.
Okay, so here it's of course L omega x over W mod phil p. When x is when r is smooth over a, the L omega is just the Durham complex, and if I had put k instead of W here, I would just have found the Durham complex, which is not what I want. So a corollary one is that for I smaller than p, then the omega I uh, x, L omega I x over W shifted by minus I is isomorphically to the Gre I for the Nagar filtration, that is by Nagar theorem to at most I of F star, and here I should put x prime here. So this is the statement on the Gre I. Now, if you take, in particular, if you take I equal to 1, then you get L omega 1, this is L x prime over W minus 1 to tau at most 1 F to star omega. So you recover the theorem 2. Now, corollary 2 is that suppose x liftable to W2, then you get a decomposition not of the truncated at most 1, but the full truncated up to P, then get isomorphism in D of x prime or x prime, sum for I smaller than P of omega I x prime minus I to tau smaller than P minus 1, that is tau smaller than P of F star omega. So this is the result in the line. So the reason is that then the liftability, you have an x tilde, then you get that L x tilde over L x over W will be a sum of O x 1 plus omega 1 x. You have a decomposition like that. And then when you take the exterior powers, you have this, which produces the minus I here. The minus 1. Okay, so then you have somehow a refinement of theorem 2. Again, the proof is a bit similar to the proof of the theorem 2. I don't think I have time to give it here, but the main point is that you first work on the affine case, and then you look at this filtration, Hodge filtration, fill I, and it is somehow similar, and in fact turns out to be quasi-isomorphic to a filtration like the JR filtration on the Durham complex of an embedding. So the embedding will be here played by, you have your R, let's say over K, and you have here the W, and then you take the P over W of R here. And so this is somehow the embedding that... So I will skip the details here, and...
So this is details for what?
What?
What you are sketching here is about...
So the proof of theorem 3. So you take R smooth over K, and then you take the free polynomial algebra over W, and then you look at the... So you consider the Durham complex, and then several filtration, and then... Okay, so I won't give the details here. There is also some prismatic variant of that, which is I'm not sure. Yeah, so which is due to BAT and for which I'm afraid there is no reference at the moment, so prismatic variant. So you have this same situation, spec, let's say S, you have T, and then the statement is that you take L omega x over t. So think of this as w and this as k. So this is my prism. I think I forgot in the previous statement, I forgot some condition on s. The prism has to be bounded, which means that here I have armored I. So armored I at infinity is I of the p to the n for n large, so you have to. So then this field p was to what? So you had our new lower star of O x over t, the prismatic thing, and phi upper star of that, and here so phi is this. And the morphism produced by the delta structure on T. And here you have some Nygaard filtration, NP, which is, well, a bit technical to define. But in the case of T is spec W, and you have the comparison between this and the crystalline cohomology. In fact, this turns out to be crystalline cohomology, or you lower star x over w. Here, this phi upper star is important. So prismatic cohomology descends crystalline cohomology. So then you find here mod np, and this is w omega, and so on. So you have this sort of thing. But in the remaining minutes, I would like to mention some thing about LCI variance, because it has some connection with some paper by B, B, L, S, Z, Bad Blick, Lubesnik, Singh, and Tang, with vanishing theorems a la Codera in singular cases, those are complex numbers, in characteristic zero. So LCI variance, so in fact, we have the W omega, but of course we like to derive this. We have a W omega, and yeah. So then you had the maybe theorem 4 that you have x over k, and no assumption x is any scheme. Then L omega x over W modulo field p. It turned out to be LW omega x divided by Nygaard NP. And this will give some degeneration and partial degeneration plus vanishing, hopefully. Not yet, I've not derived them for the moment. The generation obtained by BAT in characteristic zero by the usual spreading out argument. So the yes? Yes?
In theorem 4, you have the same conclusion as theorem
3. Sorry, is there a theorem? So, but this is derived, yes.
So X is LCI or smooth?
No, nothing. So this is very weak here. So no assumption.
Even not finite type?
Okay. No. In fact, you work. So it's a trivial thing, actually. So, but at the end, the result for the LCI case like this. So of course, if x is lifted, then you get some decomposition here on the x lifted plus LCI. You get decomposition of the conjugate filtration in the degree p minus one conjugate. Minus 1 of L omega x and the sum of L omega x prime over W I to the minus I. And then this in terms with degeneration. So one result is that x now k, now a characteristic of k is 0. So you consider the completed Durham complex. So the our lim of L omega divided by phi r. Then for x over k LCI, then n proper dimension d, and you assume that the dimension d, and you assume that the singular locus of x is s. Then for n, I will write it here, or maybe I'm over time. Yes, over time, yes, I should. So I just write some, because I started at 35, yes. Yes. So then the theorem is that the dimension for n smaller than d minus s, minus 1, then dimension of each n of x and this completion thing. So this is hn of x and c, if x n and c, if k is c. So this is a sum from g 0 to d of hn. So is this a sort of a Hodge to Durham degeneration, partial one, x l omega j, x of minus j. And the rest is 0 for j greater than d. This turned out to be 0. So here's the sum of dimension. So, and we expect some Kodera vanishing when you put some ample line bundle here. Anyway, so thank you very much.
Any questions? So what's the status in the logarithmic setup if you have some simple normal crossing divisor at infinity? Can you represent?
Yes. So of course you have the so then it is 2 minus 1 of L so you take the Gabor-Olson co-potential complex x prime over k should be minus 1 there is morphism to 2 minus 1 of F over star omega x over k, but everything taken in the log sense, and also here log sense for x x over k log smooth and Cartier type. So in particular, the x prime will lift over W2. The Teichmuller thing, the Teichmuller lifting, if and only if the Durham complex is decomposed in degree at most one. Yeah. So this was one of the results of Mao-Sheng and Shen Tu. Yeah.
Can you write the name?
Yes.
You mentioned the people who did. I didn't catch the names of the.
So yes. So there's one first name, so there is Sheng, Sheng Ma, and Sheng Tu. Yes. Sheng Ma and Sheng Tu, yes. Maybe my accent is not good, but anyway. Yes. Okay. Yes.
Any other question? Okay, so we meet again at 11:15. Yes. Okay.